106.1 Kiss FM, all the hits that's going on. I'm Gavin. It's the afternoon show. Joined in the studio now by some very special guests from Unfinished Entertainment. I've got director Doug Sharp. I've got actor Cody Webb and music director Joe Leagers here for the Both Ways the movie premiere happening this Wednesday night at Showplace Cinemas. Now, Doug, how did this movie come to be? And what is it about for people who might not know?
What is it about? It is about a small town boy band called Both Ways. Who are trying to make it big, and it's a mockumentary kind of in the vein of This Is Spinal Tap, if people are familiar with that. And then there are a lot of other plots that go along the way, like a murder trial, an election, a small budget movie, a restaurant war. It's a lot of stuff happening, and they're just right in the center of it, just trying to make their way through.
And this movie kind of came to be because it was just like a background joke in another short, right?
Yeah, it was just a movie poster we needed. It was supposed to be like a stereotypical teenage girl's bedroom. We needed some sort of a poster for that we didn't have to pay copyright for. And so we made a poster, and then we were like, oh, hey, this could be a thing. You guys can sing and act. So
now, not only is this your second feature film, but this is a movie, and I'll talk to Cody and Joe about this, but this is a movie that you actually like created a soundtrack for. And Joe, you took kind of the reins on that one, correct?
Well, somewhat. I collaborated with Laura Dalto, who couldn't be here, and we both came up with the music and the words pretty much 50-50.
Now, what was your experience like creating the soundtrack and the sound of this fake boy band?
Well, I always found myself thinking like, oh, I'm going to throw in this really interesting chord, or I'm going to change keys right here, and then I would think, wait, no, this is boy band music. Let's keep it simple. So we always tried to come up with lyrics that were really kind of stereotypical 90s boy band music. And then the craziest thing is, even after keeping it simple, I feel like this is some of the catchiest, best music I've ever worked with.
Yeah, and I've gotten to hear a few of the songs from the soundtrack, which is going to be actually available on iTunes as well, which is super cool. And it sounds like music we would play here on the station. Like, it sounds like it would mix very well with like the One Direction and the Justin Biebers. And most of that and a lot of that credit goes to Cody, who just sings like an angel, basically.
I don't know about that, but no, it is honestly some of the catchiest music ever. I mean, not just saying that just because I sang it, but I mean, if you listen to it once or twice, and then I remember when we did the first song, it's actually called Both Ways, a couple of the other guys and I, weeks later, we'd be walking around and we would start humming it, and we're like, man, it sticks with you for a long time, but it's really, really good music. And so you probably should play it on 106.1.
just a little bit.
Slide that in there.
When it starts charting, I will see what I can do. When you guys can take down Taylor Swift, then I will make my real push. But no, the soundtrack is really good. Now, Cody, were you a big fan of boy bands before taking on this role, or?
I'm actually channeling my 90s Justin Timberlake with my double denim that I have going on. I was a big fan of NSYNC. My older sister was, and Justin Timberlake was actually a big inspiration of mine. So when Doug asked me if I wanted to be in a boy band, immediately I jumped at the opportunity. Because, I mean, when I was a kid, I remember we had a tape of them, of NSYNC live at Madison Square Garden. Mm-hmm. Immediately I was like, I want to do that. I want to be up there on stage singing and dancing. And
we all had that moment. Yeah.
I still do that when right. I put in an old VHS. Like, I want to be, I would settle to be like Chris Kirkpatrick. Like, I don't even need to be Justin Timberlake. Just let me be any of them at this point. I'd be happy to be any of them. Now, Doug, the premiere is happening Wednesday. What are some deets on that? Yes, I said deets because I'm connecting with a younger audience.
Some deets. It is at 7:30 at Showplace Cinemas East. Adult tickets are $10. Children are $7. Show up early because we have, you know, all the actors will be there. There'll be a lot of mingling. We'll have the soundtrack for sale, of course. A huge banner that you can take your picture with the band. It's a lot of fun. You have to see it to really understand. But
yeah, so I'm excited. Also, humble brag, I am in this movie. I am in this. And would you say I steal the show? Would you say that
absolutely,
I am?
Absolutely.
We'll see. Well, mention that this is a spiritual sequel of sorts to another film where you might have stolen the show. Yeah,
it is. It is a spiritual sequel. I like the way you're telling me how to run my interview. Like, listen, talk about my other thing.
I'm telling you how to promote yourself, yes, Gavin.
Thank That's you all. So much. That's but all. Yeah, it is a spiritual sequel to Girl Me on Tricycles, which I actually just put up on our website, 1061evansville.com, which is free to watch until Wednesday. So, see, I did some homework. So I was in that, and then I'm happy to be in this one, and I'm definitely going to be there on Wednesday night. And you guys are actually going to stick around and actually do a song live from the movie, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, so stick around for that.